The caption for this morning meditation is, this is the refreshing. This is the refreshing. In Isaiah chapter 28 verse 12, if you got a copy of the Bible, kindly turn with us to Isaiah chapter 28 verse 12. To whom he said, this is the rest wherewith you may cause the weary to rest, and this is the refreshing, yet they would not hear. This is, that it speaks about speaking in tongues, or the experience of the Holy Spirit. This is the refreshing. We are in the times of refreshing. We go to Acts chapter 3 verse 19. Repent ye therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. The time for refreshing comes from the presence of the Lord. To experience the refreshing that comes from the Lord, we should repent and be converted. Repent and be made whole. That we must be able to experience this refreshing. This refreshing means this revival. Weary, withered, burnt out, just smoke is coming. Smoldering. Again getting a new life. That is refreshing. It is almost dead. New life is coming out of it. It is withering. Weary. Out of that a life is born. That is called refreshing. Revived. Getting a new life. Getting back what is lost. New strength. New hope. New light. New energy. Boost. I can go on and on. This is the refresh. This is the rest that causes the weary to rest. We are in the times of refreshing. The Holy Spirit is blowing upon us. First morning, the Lord gave a very powerful blessed message. Still waters. Still waters. He leadeth me beside still waters. When I was preparing that message, I was getting these Hebrew words for still and waters. That Hebrew word for still is menokava. Menokava. That menokava, it means rest. Resting place, comfort, ease, etc., etc. It speaks about a situation, more an abode, a living place where we are at home, where we are fully relaxed. Fully comfortable, no anxiety. Our own home, where we enjoy a type of a freedom. We can go to any room we want. We can lie down anywhere we want. Anytime we can open the fridge and what we want we can take. A freedom. A rest. East or west, home is best. So that still speaks about a type of a rest in Tamil, Ilaipaarthal Sthalam, Thabarasthalam, where we can live, Thabarikkirathu. A place where we can live, where we can be comfortable. And that waters speak about, in plural, a large quantity of water. When we say water in singular, even a drop of water, even piss, human urine is called water. The same Hebrew word is used. But flowing waters, rivers of living waters, sea waters, Indian waters, Bay of Bengal, Indian waters, Indian Ocean, Indian waters, Arabian Sea, Indian waters. We don't say Indian water. It's Indian waters, large quantity of waters. Where do we use that plural form of water? Either it's flowing or there are waves, then we call them waters. And also another reason why we call a flowing river waters, mighty waters of a river, gushing waters of a river. There are many tributaries for that river. Many tributaries for that river. So that water gets many different minerals, vitamins, medical properties, refreshing properties. It comes through forest. So many aromatic herbs. So those waters are rich in value in different ways. Different ways. It goes through different forests, woods, mountains. So it collects different properties. So we call that waters. It has got different values in it. Different waters are mixed in it. My dear brother, my dear sister, for you to understand how we mix waters and what is the propensity of that. See, our dear Hindu people, they understand that. When they want to take a holy dip in one place, they bring water from different places. They bring water from different places. They bring waters to Mayalapur from seven different rivers. They bring water from Kumbakonam. They pour all that water in this tank. We call that waters. So what they believe, that water will have the properties of all these holy places. Whether that could be true or not. The water from Ganges, the water from Brahmaputra, the water from Mahamaha tank. All those values will come into this one tank. My dear brother, my dear sister, understand that concept. So we see waters. Waters have got a very rich in value. Very rich in values. It has got a lot of minerals, vitamins, aromatic properties, healing properties. When we come to those waters, how refreshing that could be. When we just take some water and splash it on our face, it will be refreshing. When we have a dip in that water, it will be refreshing. When we allow those waves to come and hit on our feet, it will be refreshing. Hurling on those waters, it will be refreshing. And if you know swimming, if you can swim, how refreshing it would be. How refreshing it would be. When that water was chill and cold, not biting cold, but it was refreshing chill. And it has got some aromatic properties. It has got a citrus smell. It has got a lavender smell. It has got a sandal smell. I just have a dip in that water. How refreshing it would be. My dear brother, my dear sister, every year when we were students, Every year we used to go to Kuttalam. The water with all medical properties, refreshing properties. When we have just a bath there, oh, how refreshing it would be. How refreshing it would be. My dear brother, my dear sister, the cataracts, the waterfalls, sea, rivers, wherever we see water, good water, not muddy water, not gutter water. You just go stand before the vast sea, just behold the waves, a tranquility will descend on you. Go a little closer, you can hear the waves, a peace will set in. Just allow the gentle waves to come and hit on your feet, you'll be refreshing. Go a little deeper, stand in the ankle deep water. It depends upon the grace you have got. If somebody is hydrophobic, we may not understand what I am saying. I don't know how many of you have swum in the sea, I don't know. Anybody here? Swimming in the sea? Having a bath in the sea? Only one hand? One and a half hands? I have gone to swimming deep in sea. Wonderful. My dear brother, my dear sister, when I was meditating all these things, these still waters, these refreshing waters, waters which would make us very comfortable, is nothing but the Holy Spirit. Is nothing but the Holy Spirit. Come closer to the Holy Spirit. Allow the Holy Spirit just to splash on your face. Ankle deep, knee deep, hip deep, swimming deep. Enjoy the Holy Spirit. Even beholding the Holy Spirit, coming into the very presence of the Holy Spirit, how refreshing it would be. How refreshing it would be. My dear brother, my dear sister. So last, that first morning, when I was preaching on the still waters, I was just meditating personally on the refreshing properties of the Holy Spirit. So just I'm going to share with you a few refreshing properties of the Holy Spirit. Jesus said, Matthew 11:28, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. We have a lot of problems, we labor, we are heavy laden, family problems, children, financial constraints, pressures from the relatives, work situations, tension, depression. We don't know what to do. Pressed on all sides. When we have problem, we don't have problem. You don't have a servant, you'll have a problem. You have a servant, you'll have a problem. You are married, you have problem. You are not married, you have got problem. You have got children, you have got problem. You don't have children, you have got problem. What is constant? Problem is constant. If you don't have job, problem. If you have job, problem. Can somebody say, oh, I got job, so no problem. Not married, everybody will say, marry, marry, marry. After marriage, are the children, oh, I'm not married, oh, there's nobody to get married, etc. After marriage, why are you married? I don't have children. Pastor pray, sister pray, everybody pray. I go here, I go there, I want a child. Then the child is born. Why I have a child? Jesus says, you're heavy laden. If you don't have a work, that's a problem. If you have got a work, that's another problem. You are heavy laden. Jesus says, I'll give you rest. How will Jesus give rest? As I come to Jesus, how will I get that rest? that revival, a refreshing, the refreshing feeling. He has got a lot of properties: lavender, sandal, jasmine, rose, citrus, any aroma you could think about it. Anything that could refresh you, it's with him. It's with him. Not just a natural refreshing, spiritual, supernatural refreshing. Just I share a few things with you. Number one, this is the water that could really satisfy us. Living waters. Waters that could really satisfy our soul. We call some waters living waters because this water will never become dead water. It's always living, it's always available. Which rivers we call living rivers? Jeeva Nadi. Rivers which cannot be dead, which will not disappoint us anytime it is available. Summer, winter, autumn, spring, it is available. Water will flow in it. We cannot see Ganges dried or Brahmaputra dried, or in our place Kaveri or Tamravani dried. We call those rivers living waters. Even these waters may dry, but he is a living water. He is available for all seasons. He is available for all seasons. So this water alone can quench our thirst. Now the world is going towards a water scarcity. We may have days where we don't get waters. So here we read in John chapter 4 verse 10, Jesus answered the Samaritan woman, "If thou knowest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given the living waters." Verses 13 and 14 to save time. Jesus answered and said unto her, "Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst, water from the well, shall thirst again. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life." The water he gives, it is within us. It is not that from outside we have to take that water. It is not from our well. It is not the corporation water where the gutter is also mixed. It is not the water when you open the scorpion or the cockroach will also come. It is a living water. And that water is within. It is not an external source. He keeps that well, that fountain within. It springs forth. So you know there's no need that you have to depend on external source for your refreshing. It is within. He has said that within. You don't need an external help. He keeps it within. He has given us good lungs within that will remove the carbon dioxide and all the pollutants of the air and give free oxygen to our blood system. Small lungs is able to separate carbon dioxide and all the other pollutants from our air which we breathe in. We breathe that air that's around us with all pollutions. Within us there is a small lungs that could separate the pollution from that air and separates only the oxygen and gives this oxygen to our system, to our blood system. Kept within us. A kidney to do the work of dialysis, to remove all the impurities from our blood. Within us. Just imagine which was not, which is now given within us, is the Holy Spirit. The time of refreshing. When we receive the Holy Spirit, as you got a heart in, as you got a lungs in, as you got a kidney in, as you got a pancreas in, the Holy Spirit will be in your body. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. He is within us. He moves within us. And the function of the lungs, the function of a pancreas, much more than that, the function of the Holy Spirit within you continuously refreshes you. Continuously refreshes that you will thirst no more. You are satisfied. Married or not married? With children or no child? Yes job or no job? So hereinafter, when this system, mechanism in operation, when you receive that living waters within you, that refreshes you. Whether you get 1 lakh lottery or you don't get, whether you got a job or no job, earlier the job has to give the satisfaction. Earlier that palatial building has to give you the satisfaction. Earlier I'm married, a social status has to give you satisfaction. Earlier a child has to give you a satisfaction. That child should be a good child, then only you have a satisfaction. You should be married, then the husband should be good. Not only the husband, the mother-in-law should be good. Not only the mother-in-law, the father-in-law should be good. Not only the parents-in-law, the sister-in-law should be good. Not only the sister-in-law, her family should be good. Not only her family is good, the neighbors must be good. His husband's income must be good. So many goods can only satisfy you. Everything is outside. Everything is outside. Your husband should be good. Your husband is good. Now big question, your parents-in-law. Father-in-law is okay, mother-in-law is a problem. Mother-in-law is okay, father-in-law is a problem. Okay, parents-in-law are good. The only problem that sister-in-law. Okay, sister-in-law is good. The problem in the sister-in-law's house is the problem. Every time there is a problem for sister-in-law, that's why I got a problem. Okay, there's no problem there. The brother-in-law is the problem. He is also all right. What's the problem? I don't have a child, that's the problem. My husband is asking, my parents are asking, my parents are, what happened, what can I do? That's the problem, I don't have a child. Okay, you got a child, now what's the problem? The child is the problem. Doesn't study at all. So where are we going to end? But all these problems are around you. All these problems are around you. We cannot imagine a magic wand to change all your situations. The Lord has permitted these situations around you. The Lord has permitted these situations around you. You are with problems. But now there is a spiritual mechanism. He keeps within you. He keeps within you. That spiritual mechanism, please listen carefully, that doesn't change. We always pray, Lord, my husband should be good, my wife should be good, my parents-in-law should be good, our children should be good, etc., etc. But I tell you, your prayers may be answered, may God answer your prayers, but I tell you the truth. It's not a magic wand to change all your situations. Now He keeps a fountain, a spiritual mechanism within you that springs forth living water that satisfies you. That satisfies you. So I was meditating, how does that satisfy? Polluted air goes in. The Lord has fearfully, wonderfully created my lungs. These lungs separate carbon dioxide, all the pollutions. Within a few seconds, this carbon dioxide comes through my nostrils. The nostrils through which I breathe, through the same nostrils, carbon dioxide and all the other pollutions come out. And these small lungs takes only oxygen which is needed for my energy to burn out my energy, the burning power to my blood system. If that lungs can do that, now please listen carefully, the living waters within me, it receives all signals. Problem because of the wife, problem because of the husband, problem because of the relatives, problem in the work situation, problem because of the financial constraints. All problems were sucked into the lungs, into the kidney, into the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit separates all the burdens, and the elements for my refreshing that retains, and all the other things it ejects. Carbon dioxide is around me, but my lungs help me. Toxins go in, my kidneys help me. More than that, I am in the midst of problems, heavy laden, pressed on all sides. But as my lungs help me, as my kidneys help me, much more than the Holy Spirit that's within me helps me, that I thirst no more. Shall we, if you understand, lift up your hands and praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Only this system within us makes us refreshed. Only this system within us makes us refreshed. I can give you a number of verses on that. I don't know, to save time, I go a little fast. You can make a note of it. Revelation 21, 5 and 6. Revelation 21, 5 and 6. 22 verse 1, 22 verse 17. Where we see the water of life. Water of life. This is the water we need for living. This is the water I need for living. I cannot change my atmosphere. I need this system within. This well within, this fountain within. It should be springing forth. It should be springing forth. That meditation was wonderful to me yesterday. When this springs forth, it will be able to. This is the water for life. Life akua. Life akua. The water that can make me happy, the water that can make me satisfied, that I could live. Whithersoever this water goeth, there shall be life, there shall be health, there shall be healing, there shall be satisfaction. We are not changing the situation. The Lord is giving a purifier within you. The Lord is giving you a system that makes you refreshed in the midst of all oppressions. It's only because we don't allow the Holy Spirit to operate in our life, we go through all problems. We go through all problems. My dear brother, my dear sister. The second thing, in this rivers of living water, John 14, verses 16 to 18. From verse 16 to 18. Jesus says, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. He gives a comforter who abide with us forever. Verse 18, I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. Many times I have spoken to you what is this comfort means. Strength. Comfort. Fort means that fort, made strong, comfort, made strong. So when this Holy Spirit is refreshing with us, it's a living water, it's the water of life. We are getting strengthened, bold. It comforts us, it makes us strong, doubly strong. The very purpose of the still waters, we become very strong. I take the application of the natural situation. You are very tired, weary, fainting. You just take some water, drink it, splash it on your face, you become strong. The water that goes in releases the stored glucose from your liver. You get energy. Water is the best energy booster. Water is the best energy booster. If you take any other drink, a Complan or Boost, immediately you feel tired. Because your energy is spent on digesting that energy, that booster. Whereas pure water just releases glucose from your liver. I'm just teaching little, apply it. You feel immediately refreshed. You can go further. The Lord gave some water to Elijah. An angel came and gave some water to Elijah, bread and water. Elijah was able to walk for 40 days in that strength. In that strength. Just imagine that water is a medicinal water, herbal water. That water is honey sweetened water. Naturally, that water has got some properties that could refresh you. Just take a sip of that water, mineral water. What we take as a mineral water, now they say that we should not use the term. It's only a purified water, or a drinking water, or a bottled water. The literal mineral water. Once I took our children to a deep forest. We took special permission. We went to a deep forest. A forest that could be even wild animals. There I showed the real virgin water. Our children, Christy, Hepsi, they just took that water and drank. Water with all minerals, water with all herbal values, not polluted, fresh, fresh water. That's a real mineral water. It has got mineral value in it. Just imagine you drink that water, how much you will be comforted. If that water could comfort you, when you have the Holy Spirit, when you drink that Holy Spirit, when you allow the Holy Spirit to spring forth, when you speak in tongues, when you worship the Lord in tongues, this is the rest that causes the weary to rest. This is the refreshing. Speaking in tongues is not shouting, it's not yelling, it's not some mental disorder. It is refreshing. You are drinking that water. He will not leave you comfortless. That comfort is not somebody comes and say, Allah, it's not that consolation. It is that strength. Yes, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. That boldness, let come what may. He knows. So financial constraint, you are heavy laden. June is coming, how will I pay the fees? I want to give a good education to our children. I want to send them to a real good school, a private school. But where can I go for money? Heavy laden. Heavy laden. When you pre-speak in tongues, when you come into His presence, when you are immersed in the Holy Spirit, when you can swim in the Holy Spirit, when you can take a holy dip in the Holy Spirit, they all go to different places to take a holy dip. But when you take a dip in the Holy Spirit, that's immersed in the Holy Spirit, it'll be refreshing. You'll be able to face tomorrow boldly. I just tell you a true incident that took place in my life, just as a testimony. It's a time that Hepsi, I think, was finishing her EMPhil, that period. My sister's daughter was getting married, an elaborate arrangement. And she has requested me to take care of the reception side. But the food, every arrangement, she has looked into it. Just to have a small decoration, spreading the chairs, etc., etc. Some plants. For that she has given in my hand 2 lakhs. Some of her boys are also helping me. So we were in the reception grounds. The arrangements were going on. I still remember a few seconds I totally bewildered. Heavy laden, just for this arrangement, 2 lakhs. Then the food, then the other marriage expenditure. How many lakhs it would have cost my sister? I don't have a single paisa saving because I came for the ministry. We don't have a gram of gold to pledge. At least his basic needs I must be able to meet. Where will I go? The child is in marriageable age. I don't have a single paisa saving. God will take her. That is the comfort we receive of the Holy Spirit. Heavy laden, but He gives us rest. He gives us a mechanism within us to face tomorrow. Somehow it was not in my conscious mind after that. And in that January I went for a program in Madurai, especially in the midst of the AIDS patients, conducted by some NGOs, retired bank officers, retired DSP. So they all were conducting that program. It was heart moving. About 200 AIDS victims were there. Their children, about 40, were there. Keep all 200 AIDS victims to preach to them, it was a big challenge. And these NGOs, they contribute for the travel of some of them and also for the food, etc. So I asked that organizer how much it would cost. They said an amount. Immediately I thought that I should contribute for that program. So in that January, I gave a check to that tune. That time it was really a big amount for me. It's really a big amount for me. In the same year, her marriage, everything was finalized. And next, in the beginning, her marriage was over. I just calculated. Expenditure is exactly 100 times against that check. 100 times of that check. Not one paise, I was in debts. For the glory of the Lord, I say this. Not one paise, I was in debts. Comfort. Boldness. That's why we were able to resign our job. It's 6 mouths to feed. we came out for the ministry. Not by looking at anybody. Not looking at anybody. This is the strength of the Holy Spirit. This is the comfort we get from the Holy Spirit. So when we go to that refreshing still waters, when you allow that fountain to spring forth, my dear brother, my dear sister, we will be refreshing. This is the refreshing, otherwise we are heavy laden. Number three, what is the property? What is the property in this living waters? A satisfaction, comfort. Number three, Romans 14:17. For the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. Joy in the Holy Ghost. Not only joy, peace, gentleness, all the fruit of the Spirit. You don't have time to take all those things. Unspeakable joy. Peace that passeth all understanding. Calmness, gentleness. Because it quenches my thirst, is the water of life. Because it comforts me, I get the fruit of the Spirit. I get the fruit of the Spirit. There may be a besetting situation with all this preparation. With all this preparation, though bubbling in joy, moving to prayers, there were besetting situations. Nevertheless, when this fountain is in operation, we get that joy, we get that peace, we get that gentleness. Just imagine there is no situation that could beset us, then I cannot test this power. Nilalin arume veilla than ther. The how much you have studied, that can be seen only in a test. If there is no test, you cannot find out how much you have studied. So tests are essential. At times that test may be very hard. The question may be, somebody asked me, nee question paper lighter irundha paper weighta irundhi. Question paper lighter irundha paper weighta irundhi. Paper evlo weight irukku andha weight thana question paper irukku. That's the weight of the paper. He will not give a question paper out of syllabus, don't worry. He will not give you a question paper out of syllabus. He may ask you tough questions. You know, how do they test the IQ? A child 10 years old. To test the IQ of that child, they'll give a test a 10-year-old child can take. The child passes. Then to the 10-year-old child, they give a paper that 11-year-old child can do. Then a 12-year-old child can do. The question paper will become tougher and tougher. Then only your intelligence quotient. IQ means intelligent quotient. Your IQ can be tested. Your IQ can be tested. And if you are able to answer only a question paper that is for your age, you are normal. You are not intelligent. Only when you are able to answer a question that for 12 year or 13 year, 15 year, your intelligent quotient increases. Similarly, in the spiritual area also, He may give a tougher test to some people because their calling and their commitment, it's more. They'll be able to handle it. God wants them to go soar higher and higher and higher and higher. The test would be higher and higher and higher. But as long as that spirit is within you, the test may be tougher, but there will be joy. The test is external, joy is internal. You are selected for your school team. You go for an inter-school competition in your zone. You play very well. You are selected for your zone. Then you go for inter-zonal competition. Your state is divided into 4 zones or 8 zones. From all the zones people come. Every team is a tougher team. It's not like the school team. It's not like inter-school match. It is a very tough team. Teams from all zones have come. You play very well, you are selected in your state. The interstate match is coming. From Tamil Nadu, from Kerala, from Punjab, from Calcutta, from Delhi, teams are coming. Now the competition is very tough, the match is very tough. They are not bachas like your school friends. From Delhi they come, from Punjab they come, all like giants they are standing. You are playing very well. You are selected for a national team. You are selected for a national team. Tougher the match, stronger you are. Stronger you are. The match is outside. Whether you play for your school or play for your zone or you play for your state or play for your country, the match is outside. But the strength is within you. The strength is within you. Every time you win, you feel the joy. Then you started jumping. I am the champion, I am the champion, I am the champion. That's the joy of the Holy Ghost. That's the joy of the Holy Ghost. I don't say that you don't have battles. But if the spiritual mechanism is within you, you will not cry and go away. You will not say, I don't want any opponents. Just imagine a game of a football. A great spiritual value with a day-to-day application, I'm saying. How many have played a game like football or hockey? Something like that. Anybody? Those have played team games, volleyball. No, only a few people. No game. Just imagine football or hockey. I was a hockey player. Just imagine a football. The ball, the center is kicked. So the center forward is taking the ball. No one attacks. He looks this side and that side. No one attacks. He go to the goal post.
The goalkeeper moved away.
He doesn't block your ball. You give a free kick. The ball is brought back to the center. Again the center kick is given. Nobody attacks. How long you can play the game? The beauty of the game is the opponent. You can enjoy the game when the opponent is strong. You cannot play the game when the opponent, if the weaker, there is no opponent. But why do we say in life situation we don't want any problems? We don't want any problems. When I learned driving, long back, I was just 26 or 27 at that time. One military captain, he gave me 2 suggestions. And one of them, never enjoy driving on an open ground. Never enjoy driving on an open ground. any bachcha or even a timid woman can drive. Just press the accelerator, the vehicle will go. If you don't know to apply the brake, there will be at least a tree. Somehow you can manage. Don't enjoy that. Enjoy driving in a crowded area. Enjoy drive. Don't get tensed up. One will come from the left, one will come from the right, one will go on the wrong side, one will suddenly apply the brake in front of you. So you are maneuvering in that. That's a real enjoyment. There's a real enjoyment. When I was driving, a brother who used to go with me, he always used to say this one thing. Nanga nee hockey-la ball kondu pona mari car kondu poringa. Hockey-la ball kondu pona mari car kondu poringa. Doesn't mean that I'll go left, right, left, right, left, right. But I used to enjoy. I wouldn't get tensed up. Similarly, the real joy of the Holy Ghost is not that we don't have opponents. The real joy is when you go through the opponents and find victory. Somebody has to stop you. Somebody wants to stop your progress. Somebody wants you not to gain that goal. Somebody wants you not to have victory. Somebody wants to knock you down. As I told you last Sunday evening from cricket. Two people are there, batsman and bowler. Every single ball, the bowler bowls, his only aim to knock you out. He is not bowling a ball that you could take runs. The Lord has kept your mother-in-law, your daughter-in-law, your neighbors around, everybody around you. The 10 people around you. Why are they standing there? Just when you take runs and they stand and clap hands? They all are standing around you to see how they can knock you out. They are not standing there to help you. But your joy depends upon how you handle the ball. You should not tell you, no, throw the ball lightly. Throw the ball lightly. You can't tell him. You can't say that, Lord help me. Everybody is throwing the ball at me. No. That's the joy. Play the ball carefully. Game. The joy of the Holy Ghost. This is within us. So when we have these living waters within us, we enjoy that. That's why we read in Psalm 16 verse 11. Thou wilt show me the path of life. This is the path of life. Thou wilt show me the path of life. Thou wilt show me the path of life. In thy presence is fullness of joy. At thy right hand there are pleasures forevermore. That is the path of life. What is the path of life? Joy in His presence. Fullness of joy. Pleasure in His presence. That He gives within us. This is the refreshing. Pray in tongues, speak in tongues. The spring, I love the spring. The fountain to spring forth water. That Holy Spirit. Go into His presence. As a deer panteth for the water brooks, find water. Just go into His presence. Go into your prayer closet. Worship the Lord. Pray in tongues. Praise God. The peace that passeth all understanding. Joy unspeakable. Victory. The world will look at you and say, who is she? Who is she? Leaning on the bosom of her husband in the wilderness. That's the path of life. He's in the wilderness. Scorching wilderness. I lean on the bosom of my Jesus Christ. I cannot change the wilderness, but I can choose the bosom of my beloved. I cannot change the wilderness, but I can choose the bosom of my beloved. There I find my joy. There I find my happiness. How wonderful it is. So, the first morning when I was meditating on the still waters, I was meditating on the properties in that still waters. It's the water that quenches my thirst. It's the water that comforts me. It's the water that produces the fruit of the Spirit in my life. Number 4, John 14:70. This is the problem with many of us, with all of us. We don't know how we are, but when others are bad, we cannot tolerate. How many of you would be happy that if your child speaks lies? Anybody? Anybody will say, I'll be very happy if my child speaks lie? Anybody? How many of you would be happy that your husband speaks lies? Anybody will say, I'm very happy if my husband speaks lies. I allow him to speak lie. Anybody here? Can any man say, I love my wife only if she speaks lie? Nobody. But the problem, we are allowed to speak lies. We don't want others to speak lie. The problem would become greater when we also don't want to speak lie. You don't want to speak lie. You don't want your husband to speak lie. He speaks lie. You cannot tolerate. You feel that you cannot live with him. You feel that he is not trustworthy. How can I believe him? How can I believe her? I know she speaks lie. One lady said, "Vittukar vaaya therandale poi solluvar." How to live with that man? In Tamil, yana avaroda kuppa kottalam, but how to live with him? When he says, "I love you," can she believe him? When he says, "I don't have anybody in my heart," can we have an open heart surgery to find out whether he has got any more wife plus in his heart? But we know that he is a liar. We are heavy laden. One problem we all face, when people around us are not true, we cannot believe anybody. We are unable to believe neighbors. We are unable to believe the politicians. I am interested in these chat shows, especially these sometimes the political chat shows. But more and more it is sickening. It is sickening. Everybody seems to be a fraud. They have taken bribes, you have taken bribes, you have taken bribes, everybody has taken bribes. They are not honest. We could not see honest people. We are becoming sick. In government, no satyam. In business, no satyam. There is an industry going on, everybody knows, it's an industry to break stones, just like rice, to that size, to mix it with rice. There is an industry, I don't know how many of you are aware of it, going on to make small balls of clay, just like black grams. Ulundu mari. களிமண்ணை உருட்டுறதுக்குன்னே ஒரு தொழில் நடக்கு. எனிபடி அவேர் ஆஃப் இட்? தட் சிஸ்டர், வி ஆர் லிவிங் இன் திஸ் வேர்ல்ட். வி ஆர் லிவிங் இன் திஸ் வேர்ல்ட். அன் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி இஸ் கோயிங் ஆன். பீப்புள் ஆர் ஒர்க்கிங். making clay like Bengal grams add to ulundu. They are breaking stones for the size of rice to add to rice. I can go on and on. In tea leaves, in coffee powder. We don't see truth anywhere. We become sick. We become sick. We are unable to believe anybody. We are unable to believe our own children. We are unable to believe our own parents. We are unable to believe our own co-borns. We are unable to believe our own neighbors. We are unable to believe our own boss. We are unable to believe our own servants. We are unable to believe our own government. We are unable to believe our own businessmen. Somewhere we are becoming sickening. In this world, this living waters, this still waters is called the Spirit of Truth. To save time, I just give you the verses. John 14, 17. John 15, 26. John 16, 13. 1 John 4, 6. We call that Spirit of Truth. It's the truth. Whatever it says, it's the truth. Whatever it says, it's the truth. A few days back, one brother came and told something. I just believed. I said, yes, okay. A few seconds, I just moved into my room. The Spirit of the Lord told me, at least I knew in my spirit, he was lying. I called him. I said, is this not a lie? He tried to cover up for some time. Then he said, yes, I became very sick. Whom to believe? Whom to believe? Very easily they speak lies. Once when I told him, why are you lying? He said, I am not lying. Oh, you are calling me a liar. I said, it's not, is it true? No, I can't, I can't. ஏங்க பாரு என்ன சொல்றது அத அதான் பொய்யின்னு சொல்ல முடியாம என்ன சொல்றது வெரி ஈஸிலி வி ஆர் அன்ஏபிள் டு ட்ரஸ்ட் எனிபடி வென் ஐ கான்ட் ட்ரஸ்ட் சம்படி இன் ஒன் ஏரியா ஹவ் வில் ஐ ட்ரஸ்ட் ஹிம் இன் அனதர் ஏரியா த ஒன்லி ஒன் இன் திஸ் செகண்ட் வேர்ல்ட் த ஸ்பிரிட் ஆஃப் ட்ரூத் Whatever he says, that is the truth. I can depend on one person. That consoles me. That consoles me. When that operates in another person, then we too will become speak truth. It operates in the third person, it operates in the fourth person. It's the Spirit of Truth. It will not change. That love will not change. The truth is not only speak, it's not only against lies. Truth literally means unchanging. Unchanging. Truth literally means sat. Sat, not changing. Not changing. Satyam, not changing within. Situations may change. He doesn't change. His words will not change. His promise will not change. We are unable to depend on anybody's promise. We are unable to depend on anybody's promise. Many years back, I still remember, I went for fasting prayers alone in a room. I was praying for many people. Just remembering them. In the presence of God, I praying for them. There was a man who was always with me, helping me. Just I remembered him. I was praying for him. The same size, his figure, as I was just remembering him and praying, the whole size, suddenly I saw like a scorpion. Suddenly I saw like a scorpion. The whole scorpion standing before me. I said, I tried to erase it. I said, there was some imagination. Because he was always with me. But after some time, the pains I endured because of that brother. He's a very nice brother. God permitted it. My dear brother, my dear sister, we are unable to depend on anybody. He is alone the spirit of truth. So we are heavy laden because we are unable to depend on anyone. Depend on him. So when we have this, when we come to the still waters, I just remind you, taking that water and splashing on your face, drinking that water, paddling in that water, ankle deep, knee deep, hip deep, swimming in that water, having a holy dip in that water, moolgi elumbaname, playing in that water, trying to see the bottom of that water. I don't know how many of you had the jump into the well, going to the bottom of the well and taking the sand. We used to play 25 feet deep and all, I have gone to take sand. Just go in and take sand and come. In the Holy Spirit, going deeper and deeper and deeper, enjoying. That is the only, the spirit of truth. You can enjoy the truth in him. There is no falsehood in him. His promises are true. His love is true. He is never changing. So number 5, this Holy Spirit, why are we heavy laden? When we become thirsty, when we are not satisfied, when there is no comfort, we become weary, there is no joy or the fruit of the Spirit. Then here we saw the fourth one, when we don't see the truth. And the fifth one, when we don't get the proper guidance. So what is the refreshing propinquity in this water? This water gives us the right guidance. We read that in 1 John chapter 2 verses 26-27. 1 John chapter 2 verses 26-27. He teaches you all things. When you have to turn to the left or to the right, it shows you which direction you should go. He leads you. In your business, in your ministry, in my business, the Spirit of the Lord leads me what I should preach. His system has not dried up all these years. 1977 I got saved. 1972 I got saved. 73 January, within 4 months, I preached in a convention in Tirunelveli in a CSA church. In the same year, March, I preached in Bandroti convention. May, I preached in Silavam general convention. Within a few months since I got saved, since I received the Holy Spirit, October 72, I received the Holy Spirit. In May 73, I was preaching in one of the biggest general conventions of Tamil Nadu at that time. From that time till this time I am preaching. His words have never got exhausted. There are many areas I feel that I have not finished preaching. I am preaching this congregation for more than 25 years. is not dried up. It will not dry up. He will guide you. He will guide you. In my business, He guides me. In your business, He will guide you. In bringing up your children, He will guide you. When you have to turn to the left or to the right, your ears will hear, this is the way, walk here. He will teach you to profit. He will teach you to profit. Even in the days of drought, He will guide you. He is a spirit that guides us. We become weary when we don't know the direction. We become directionless. Directionless. We become very weary, heavy laden. When we don't know what's the decision we make, what choice we could make. Many people, because they lean to their own understanding, they lose the peace of mind. The more you take up this guidance, you'll have that refreshing, God is with me. The Lord led me to this ministry. Decisions the Lord helps me to take. When the Lord helps me take decisions, I feel no sorry. That is the refreshing. That is the refreshing. Even in small matters, I was to pay a gift to somebody. Whether I should give that gift or I need not give that gift, that's a small Isaac and Ishmael, boxing, wrestling. The Holy Spirit said, give. Okay, settle, give. Guidance. My mind was saying no. Another said, no, give. Yes, no, yes, no. Holy Spirit said, give, okay. Very easy to take decision when the Spirit of the Lord leads us. When He told me to resign job, it's very easy for me. When He told me to start this ministry, it's very easy for me. He goes before me, He goes with me. He is the vanguard. He is my protector. He is all around me. He guides me. When we know that He guides us, our decisions are very simple. So He quenches our thirst. He comforts us. He fills us with the fruit of the Spirit, and we can depend on He is the Spirit of the truth, and He guides us. And number 6, Acts chapter verse 1:8, He gives us the power to be His witness. He gives us the power to be His witness. My dear brother, my dear sister, it is the power of the Holy Ghost. Is not to give witness, not to preach about Jesus, to be a witness for Jesus. Many a time we misunderstand, we receive the Holy Spirit that we can go and do ministry. To preach about Jesus Christ, you don't need the Holy Spirit. To preach about Jesus, you don't need the Holy Spirit. A politician will speak very good about Jesus. If he has got alliance with Jesus, he'll say Jesus is good. Next day when he has got alliance with the devil, he'll say Jesus is bad and devil is good. And he will not be ashamed to have alliance with Jesus on the third day and he'll say Jesus is really good. And now we can understand, anytime he'll have alliance with the devil next election. There's a politician. So you give to him, he'll preach Jesus is good. So to preach about Jesus, you don't need the power. But to have a life of witness, what Jesus said, I love that, I could read it first. But you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me. You shall be witnesses unto me. It's not that you shall be witness about me. You shall be a witness to the world and to me, for the world to know who I am, for the world to know what I can do. You are the witness. You are the evidence. You are the evidence. You are the evidence what Jesus is, what Jesus can do. So we receive that power. So in this world, we can be a witness unto Jesus. We can be a witness unto what we believe. We can be a witness unto what we profess. So we receive a living water. We receive comfort. We receive joy. We receive truth. And we receive guidance. We receive power. And one more thing, I just conclude with this. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 verses 17 and 18. 17 and 18. Now the Lord is that Spirit. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. But we all with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even as by the Spirit of the Lord. We are led into perfection. Glory upon glory. Holiness upon holiness. Righteousness upon righteousness. More and more into His image. This is the refreshing. This is the refreshing. When I was at my desk preparing this, when I was just about to close the preparation, the power and points he gave, only the presentation, I was about to close, suddenly sprang forth the word of God as a prophecy. Isaiah 42 verse 16. Isaiah chapter 42 verse 16. And I will bring the blind by a way they knew not. I will lead them in paths that they have not trodden. I will make darkness light before them, and crooked things straight. These things will I do unto them, and not forsake them. In this process of perfection, this was very new to me last night. Anything that is dark, He'll make bring light. Anything that is crooked, He will make straight. Anything that is hard, He will make that smooth. He will perfect things in your life. The areas where it is blind today, He will show you light. The areas where you see it's crooked, He will make it straight. The areas where you say this is very hard, He will make that smooth. My dear brother, my dear sister, in the morning when the Lord told me that I should speak about the properties in that still waters, that I meditate, that I just mentioned on first morning message, I didn't know what I was going to say. It was very hard. It was very hard. I was blind. I didn't know what I was going to speak. I was blind. He led me in the path I have not known. He led me in the way that I have not trodden before. He turned the darkness into light, the crooked things into straight, the hard things smooth. I do all these things and I will not forsake you. In the name of Jesus, I promise you. In the process of perfecting you, why are you heavy laden? Why are you weary? Certain things, you are blind. You don't know what your future holds for you. You don't know what tomorrow holds for you. You don't know what will happen to you if your parents pass away, husband pass away, wife passes away. What will happen if your children leave you? What will happen to your daughter, to your son? What will happen next? You are weary, you are heavy laden. You are very heavy laden. In the name of Jesus, I tell you, He will turn your darkness to light. You think it's very difficult to go in this path. He tells you, I will make the hard path smooth. Everybody is crooked. Their words are perverted. They are not very honest. I am unable to bear it. I am unable to believe anything. The Lord tells you, my son, my daughter, I will straighten the crooked things. I will do all these things and I will not leave you. How refreshing it is. Shall we stand to our feet? Come closer to the living waters. Come closer to the living waters. Hallelujah. You are weary. You are heavy laden. Hallelujah. Come closer to the living waters. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Come closer, come closer, come closer. Hallelujah. It's not a muddy water. It's not a gutter water. Pure water, crystal clear water. Water coming from the throne of God and the Lamb. Hallelujah. Come closer to that water. Come closer to that water. Hallelujah. It's very aromatic. It's not the stink of a gutter. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The smell of the rose is there. The smell of the lavender is there. The smell of the herbs is there. The smell of the beautiful flowers of the forest is there. The smell of the sandal is there. Hallelujah. Take that water, my son. Take that water, my daughter. Splash it on your face. Splash it on your face. How refreshing it is. How refreshing it is. Come closer to those water. Come closer to that water. Don't be afraid of it. It's not the sea that will, hallelujah, swallow you up. It is not the sea that will swallow you up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let those waves come in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let those waves come and caress your feet. Let those waves come and caress your feet. Hallelujah. Come closer. Come closer. Hallelujah. From your soul to the head of, to from your, the sole of your feet to your head, the chillness is going through. Oh, clap your hands. Enjoy that refreshing. Enjoy that refreshing. The waves are coming and kissing your feet. The waves are coming and caressing your feet. Come closer. Come closer. Ankle deep. Knee deep. Hip deep. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All your tensions are relieved. All your burdens are relieved. You come heavy laden. Hallelujah. You went to your father. You went to your mother. You went to your friend. Your burden was increasing. Your burden was increasing. Come unto me, come unto me, heavy laden, I give you rest, I give you rest. Hallelujah. His guidance, his power, his living water, his truthfulness. Oh, how refreshing it is. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worship the Lord. Lift up your hands and worship the Lord. There is healing. There is healing. There is health. There is joy. As the lungs would remove all the pollutant and only separate the oxygen, as your kidney will remove all the toxins and only separate the needed food. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All your worries, all your problems are filtered and ejected by this Holy Spirit that is within you. Hallelujah. All your anxieties are relieved. What are you going to do? Just lift up your hands and speak in tongues for a few minutes. This is the rest that causes the weary to rest. This is the refreshing. They don't understand it. They don't understand it. Those who are weary, those who are heavy laden, lift up your voice. Feel the presence of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is the path of life. This is the path of life. What is the path of life? Joyfulness. Fullness of joy in His presence. Hallelujah. Pleasures on His right hand. Enjoy the presence of God close by your side. Uri namarabha, di namarabha. In the world of worries, in the world of anxiety, in the world of care. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Within and without, there is a sister you can enjoy. You can enjoy. When people are coming against you, no more
more you are weary. No more you are weary. You are enjoying your victory. You are enjoying your trophy. You are enjoying your success. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Nandri andavare. Let your living water flow on my soul. Let your Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Come and abide. This Holy Spirit experience you cannot have real revival, springing back to life. Your money, your job, your family, your worldly success, nothing can give this real refreshing to you. Real guidance, real power, the real fruit of the Spirit, the real perfection. Enjoy the living waters. He leads you beside still waters. Bless your people, O Lord. Bless them with all your heavenly benedictions. And send your people back home with your heavenly benedictions. Let them experience this refreshing. Speaking in tongues, enjoying in the Holy Spirit, a fountain within you, O Lord. Bless your people. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. God bless you all. God be with you. Shalom. Aleichem. God bless you.